Before starting this video, I do want to give a thank you to my patrons that support the channel. And if you would like to support the channel, there are some great benefits for you in the link down below. So with that, let's get into today's video. Hey, what's going on YouTube? This is Devin coming back at you with another video today in Pub Stomp MTG. So with this video, I decided to make the Ultimate Jurassic Park deck. Something that I've been brewing for myself because, of course, I've been wanting to make a lot of different decks for Jurassic World, and this is the one I decided to put the most effort in specifically. This is my own deck list. If you do want to go see the deck list, you can check it down below in the link in Moxfield. Also, I do want to give a thank you to my sponsor of this video, which is Into the AM. Honestly, I love this t-shirt design company. There's a lot of great designs like this Sasquatch t-shirt. And right now they do have a Black Friday sale where you can get shirts like this. You could use my link down below so that you could help support the channel and get a great discount on your graphic t-shirts. So going back to Jurassic World, this is an excellent pairing with Blue Loyal Raptor and Owen Grady Raptor Trainer. There are a lot of other dinosaurs to consider from Jurassic World, at least from the Jurassic World Lost Caverns of Ixalan series, like the Indominus Rex or also the Indoraptor. However, Blue Loyal Raptor and Owen Grady are basically the perfect pairing for dinosaurs specifically because they focus on them the most. The Indoraptor, it focuses on getting damage dealt to itself and making itself bigger. The Indominus Rex is all about itself, making sure that you put a bunch of keywords on it so that you can make it an unstoppable force. But with Blue Loyal Raptor and Owen Grady, they're all about buffing up all your other dinosaurs on the battlefield, and so we do want to take advantage of that. So recently I did make a video about Blue Loyal Raptor and Owen Grady Raptor Trainer, but I decided I did want to make a different version, more of a high-powered version, one that honestly I could see playing myself. The other version was more of a guide of how to build around it. This is more of a definitive version that I'm planning on making myself in paper. I do have about, I want to say 50% of it done. I do have Owen Grady Raptor Trainer. I'm still waiting to get Blue. I did order a bunch of Jurassic World cards, and I just barely ordered the Secret Lair, which absolutely looks incredible. I plan on buying about three of those things, at least for the Jurassic Park alone. So, honestly, this is a very exciting set, one that I could only dream of, and it's finally in reality. And so, with Blue Loyal Raptor and Owen Grady Raptor Trainer, this is an excellent deck. So let's first read what they do before getting into the rest of the video. So Blue Loyal Raptor, it does have partner with Owen Grady. For each kind of counter on Blue Loyal Raptor, each other dinosaur you control enters the battlefield with a counter of that kind on it. So recently in my previous video, I made a mistake on that where if you have 2-1-1 counters on it, each dinosaur would enter the battlefield with 2-1-1 counters on it. That is actually false. Don't take that advice from the previous video. This is an updated video. And so for each kind of counter on Blue, you put a counter on each other dinosaur that enters the battlefield. So if Blue has 3 1-1 counters on it, you're going to have 1 1-1 counter enter with another dinosaur coming on the battlefield. So I just wanted to clarify that. I definitely own up to that mistake there. But we do want to go over Owen Grady Raptor Trainer. This is also an excellent partner commander with Blue because obviously you're going to be putting counters on Blue so that you can get other counters on your other dinosaurs. So you could tap it to put your choice of a Menace, Trample, Reach, or Haste counter on target dinosaur. Activate only as a sorcery. So I feel like personally the best choices for me personally would be Menace and also Haste. I'd probably give Blue Haste first besides anything else. Then I would do Menace, then Trample, then Reach. I mean, it really depends on if your opponents are playing big, scary flyers, then you might need to change your priority as far as putting Reach first. But for me personally, I think Haste might be the most important one, then Menace, then Trample. So for me personally, I do feel like these are the best dinosaur commanders out there. I know there's Gishath or Pantlaza. I feel like this is actually better than them because you do have access to Blue. You have access to the basically a lot of counter magic. In this deck, it is a higher powered deck, so there's a lot of free spells like Deflecting Swat and Fierce Guardianship and cards similar to those. So getting into the video, I do first want to talk about counter synergies before I do get into the good stuff. So for example, Ozolith and Ozolith Shattered Spire, these are both excellent in the deck. The Ozolith, whenever your dinosaurs die, you basically store those counters that were on your dinosaurs and you put them onto the Ozolith, and you can put them on Blue to put more counters on all the other dinosaurs. And so the Ozolith is a great fit. Also with Ozolith Shattered Spire, You're just essentially putting more 1-1 counters on your dinosaurs that enter the battlefield, and you could also, on top of that, have that ability to put 1-1 counters on target artifact or creature you control, and you have that cycling ability, so there's a lot of versatility with that second version of the Ozolith. Outside of Owen, you also want to put different kinds of counters because it's just limited to 4 different counters, so I did think of Slippery Bogbonder and Spectacular Showdown, because you could either put a Hexproof counter on blue, then put Hexproof on all your other dinosaurs, or you could put a Double Strike counter on blue, then put Double Strike on all the other your dinosaurs you control, so these are two excellent choices to put in the deck for sure. But if you really want to go full out as far as putting counters and the right type of counters on your dinosaurs, Tyrite Sanctum might be your best bet, because it could put a 1-1 counter on blue, and on top of that make blue into a god. How funny is that? And on top of that, you could sacrifice it paying 4 mana to give an indestructible counter on blue too. But I do feel like this is a good investment. Putting 1-1 counters on your dinosaurs just for paying 2 mana is pretty decent rate by itself. And on top of that, if you do want to give indestructible to blue, to give indestructible to all your cards, you definitely can as well. So the big theme of my deck is only the strongest can survive. So for example, when I thought about that, I thought about a lot of different options because we have Savage Order in the set for Jurassic World. I kind of went with that theme. You're sacrificing a dinosaur to get a bigger dinosaur out on the battlefield. Same with Natural Order, same kind of thing where you're sacrificing a green creature and putting a bigger creature on the battlefield that's green too. So I went with a little bit of a theme to sacrifice cards to get bigger cards on the battlefield. Another option I did think about was also Neoform and Eldritch Evolution. These both have that ability to sacrifice a creature and basically search for a bigger creature. With Eldritch Evolution, it has that versatile side where you can search for 2+ to sacrifice creature's mana value or less, so that's a pretty good option there too. And if you do want a good consistent way of sacrificing your little dinosaurs to make them into even bigger dinosaurs, Birthing Pod might be your best bet too, because really, it's a constant way of doing so, all for 1 mana or 2 life, or if you want to just pay 2 mana, you could easily do so, and you can kind of go back and forth, you could keep potting up into bigger and bigger dinosaurs. But another fun way I don't see a lot of people talking about is using Descendant's Fury. This is actually a really excellent card in this deck and many tribal-specific kind of decks too, so whenever one or more creatures you control deal combat damage to a player, you may sacrifice one of them. If you do, you reveal cards from the top of your library until you reveal a creature card that shares a creature type with a sacrificed creature, and you put the card onto the battlefield and the rest on the bottom of your library in a random order. So, again, I don't see this talked a lot in this type of strategy, but I feel like it's perfect because if you just swing with like a little small creature that's a dinosaur and you flip over into a Galta, I see that as a success. So, honestly, Descendant's Fury can be a very relevant card in this deck for sure. But of course, if you are sacrificing creatures using all these different methods to kind of pot up and kind of put bigger creatures on the battlefield, but of course you do want to get some value out of your dinosaurs, especially when they do die to those pot effects. So for example, Skullspore Nexus is excellent. You can basically almost guarantee just 2 green mana just to pay for this instead of that other 6, because this spell will cost X less to cast, where X is the greatest power among creatures you control. And of course, we are playing big stompy dinosaurs, so this is very easy to do. It also does have that ability: when a creature you control dies, you make a green fungus dinosaur creature token with base power and toughness each equal to the power of those creatures. And basically, you can pay 2 and tapping it double target creature's power and until end of turn. So again, this is excellent because for one, we could make big dinosaurs out of those dinosaurs that we did sacrifice with the pot effects, and on top of that, we could double the power of our dinosaurs too. But of course, if we do have a lot of dinosaurs in our graveyard, we could actually still take advantage of that by using cards like Dino DNA. This is excellent because for flavor reasons, this is how the dinosaurs were made, and it does have that imprint ability. You could pay 1 and tapping it, exile target creature card from a graveyard, activate only as a sorcery. So honestly, that by itself could be very useful. So for example, if you just exile a Dockside Extortionist from another opponent's graveyard, you could easily just keep on making those Dockside Extortionists by paying into that 6 cost. So when you do pay into that 6 cost, you create a token that's a copy of target creature card exiled with Dino DNA, except it's a 6-6 green dinosaur creature token with trample, and you only activate as a sorcery. So let's go back to that Dockside Extortionist example. Say for example you did exile one, and then you just pay into that so that you get a 6-6 green dinosaur Dockside Extortionist on the battlefield, which honestly is kind of funny. And say for example you made 6 treasure off of that. So You can just keep repeating that process until you have like an infinitely large 6-6 dinosaur armies that are called Dockside Extortionists. Honestly, I kind of find that funny and just something I just thought about on the spot. But aside from that, Dino DNA is an excellent card for sure, because you could revive all your previous dinosaurs that you did kill off of those pod effects. But of course, we are building to the theme of Jurassic World, so there's a lot of thematic choices we do want to put in the deck. So for example, if you're going to get any type of basics, of course you're going to get the ones that came out of there. I do love especially the mountain where it shows the T-Rex roaring where the volcano is exploding. Also, the island is pretty chilling with the Mosasaurus coming behind that submarine. And obviously the classic Velociraptor scene where they're kind of coming out of their cage so that they can kill a lot of the people that are in the Jurassic Park movie. And so as far as flavor reasons, these are must-includes if you are putting them in the deck. I feel like they're actually really cheap for the non-foil ones, as far as I remember looking at them. I think I got all of them, like, 10 a piece for about, like, $1 per piece, so it's not too bad. Also, another Commander All-Star is using Command Tower. This is a no-brainer, because, of course, this will tap for teamer colors in our specific Commander color combination, and so this is just a perfect fit, and also the art is absolutely gorgeous, showing the Brontodon with its little Brontodon, so... Of course you gotta add it because it's another Jurassic World card. But I did also want to bring up the Cresting Mosasaurus because of course it's basically like a whelming wave for dinosaurs. You put all non-dinosaur cards back to their owner's hand, and so that would include us as well if we do have Owen on the battlefield. But honestly, we're gonna get so much more advantage out of this. And of course we do have to add Welcome to Jurassic Park. So this is a great saga basically. I don't want to go over it too much because I feel like many of you know what this does, but if you go to the backside, I feel like that's where the money is, and honestly really pulls the weight. It has that ability for dinosaurs to have escape in the graveyard, and on top of that is a Gaia's Cradle for dinosaurs. So honestly, this is a great thematic choice and obviously a great include in any dinosaur deck to come. But of course, I do also want to mention Indominus Rex. This came out of the first Jurassic World movie, not the Jurassic Park movie, but Jurassic World movie, and it's a reskin of the Polyraptor, so I feel like this could be extra deadly in this deck. I didn't add too much Enrage dinosaurs in this deck specifically, but the Indominus Rex, of course, for flavor reasons, we have to include this in. The more Polyraptors we do enter the battlefield with, the more they will get those abilities of blue, and this could be extra deadly for sure. But I will be honest, nothing beats the classic movies like the first Jurassic Park. That is my favorite movie of all time. If I had to make a tier list, that would be my number one, because not only is it just a big, giant, scary dinosaur movie, but there's a lot of philosophical things as well within that movie that I do find very entertaining. But aside from that, there's a lot of cool dinosaurs that came out of the movie. Of course, hunting Velociraptor and also Velociraptor, or otherwise known as Rampaging Ferocidon in that treatment. But these are excellent choices in the deck. I do like hunting Velociraptor so that you can cheat in big dinosaurs. Make them just cost 2 and a red, so... Honestly, that's just great value by itself, and if you really want to punish those people who are playing a lot of tokens, Velociraptor is a good option for you as well. But of course, if you do want to ramp ahead, you could take advantage of Wayward Sawtooth, or otherwise known as Triceratops, in this reskin. So obviously, you can just play extra lands during your turn so that you can ramp ahead into your big dinosaurs. And the art is absolutely gorgeous, especially having that little Triceratops in the art too. So honestly, a 10 out of 10 for that for sure. But of course, another great dinosaur staple is also Regisaur Alpha, or also known as the Spinosaurus reskinned. And so other dinosaurs you control have haste, and it enters the battlefield with another 3-3 body. And so this is excellent. I don't know why this wasn't reskinned as a Tali, but here we are, and I'm not going to complain too much about it. But it's a very cool and stunning art. I do love how it has the Jurassic Park 3 art on it with a Spinosaurus. So this is a very good choice overall. And I do also wish they had another version of the Spinosaurus and not just the Regisaur Alpha, but this is just a welcome include anyways in the deck. Speaking of a Spinosaurus, or should I say Rexy, with Tyrannosaurus Rex, or otherwise known as a Tali Primal Storm. So this is what I was kind of talking about. I feel like the Spinosaurus and the Tyrannosaurus probably should have flipped, but I'm not going to talk about that too much because a Tali Primal Storm is probably one of the best dinosaurs to exist, period. Or a Tali Primal Conqueror, whichever one you want to consider. But this is one less mana than a Tali Primal Conqueror, but this does have a really good upside. When it does attack, you exile the top card of each player's library, then you may cast any number of spells from among those cards without paying their mana cost. So obviously, this is kind of in reference to the Tyrannosaurus flipping the cards, but instead you're flipping cards from the top of your opponent's library. So I do feel like that's a pretty fun, flavorful win in this card specifically. And of course, I just have to comment on the art. This is my favorite art probably Magic has done in a long time, if ever, because the border, it has the Jurassic Jeep art, and on top of that, the Tyrannosaurus just looks absolutely amazing. This is probably my favorite art piece that Magic has done for sure. But of course, I do want to mention Ravenous Tyrannosaurus. This is probably one of the best cards you could be playing in this deck because it has an insane ability of Devour 3. It can basically enter the battlefield as a really big creature, and whenever it attacks, it deals damage equal to its power up to one other target creature. Excess damage is dealt to that creature's controller instead, so what I do like about this is the fact that if you do have a lot of tokens lying around or a lot of different creatures, you can just sacrifice them to Ravenous Tyrannosaurus and then make them even bigger and just kind of go for a lot of damage. And so, honestly, this is absolutely incredible. One of my favorite cards that came out as far as the Universe of Beyond set goes. But of course, we do want to talk about some other dinosaur staples like Curious Altasaur. This is a great option for you to get some extra card draw in your deck because obviously, you want a lot of different options to draw some cards. I also did add Mystic Remora and also Rhystic Study in this deck because they're powerful, and of course, we're playing a high-powered deck, so they're obviously all-stars in the deck as well. Another insane card draw outlet is also Nezahal Primal Tide because this has the ability whenever an opponent casts a non-creature spell, you draw a card, and this does have a way to protect herself if you discard three cards. Obviously, this is also pretty good too because you have no maximum hand size, and a lot of people might want to counter this, but they can't because it can't be countered. So obviously, this is a big reason why I do feel like I want to play blue in Dinosaurs is because of this card specifically. I did previously talk about Atali Primal Storm, and I also mentioned Atali Primal Conqueror a little bit, and here it is. This is probably one of the best cards you can be playing in this deck because if you flicker it a lot, you get more value out of it, basically getting four different cards from atop of your opponent's and yourself library. So this is an excellent card too, and something you can kind of pod into because, of course, if we do have those birthing pod lines or different options, we can get these big splashy effects. But of course, if you really do hate that control player on the battlefield, you could use a card like Carnage Tyrant with a new art. I do like this a lot. I mean, I will say he definitely got chunkier than last time, but this spell can't be countered, and it has Trample and Hexproof. It has a lot of those stats that we do want, especially if we give more of those stats because of Blue's ability to put more counters on dinosaurs you control. This could be a nightmare to deal with. Another option I did want to consider is also Bone Horde Dracosaur. This is also a really good card. Utility card on top of that, even though for 5 mana flying first strike and 5/5 is not bad and nothing to scoff at all. But at the beginning of your upkeep, you exile the top 2 cards of your library. You may play them this turn. If you exile a land card this way, you make a 3/1 red dinosaur creature token. If you exile a non-land card this way, you create a treasure token. So either way, you're getting value. I feel like most of the time I've been seeing getting treasure tokens on the battlefield instead of getting a dinosaur on the battlefield, which, hey, I don't mind that at all. We want to ramp into our big dinosaurs, and this is one way to do so. So the big reason why I wanted to have those pod-like effects or natural order effects is so that I could sacrifice creatures into Galta Stampede Tyrant, so I could put all the dinosaurs from my hand onto the battlefield. And plus, Galta is a 12-12 herself, so honestly, this is the big reason why I wanted to go into more of a birthing pod kind of style. But of course, nothing beats the classic like Galta Primal Hunger. So basically, most of the time I've cast this for only 2 green mana, and 2 mana trample 12-12 isn't a bad rate. And of course, I had to add the special guest art because honestly, it's one of my favorite arts. I would say now that the new Tyrannosaurus art has been released, this has been kind of dethroned because the other art is really incredible. Don't get me wrong, this is probably my top 5 favorite arts of all time in Magic the Gathering too, but they've been really nailing it out of the park as far as the dinosaurs go. So honestly, I really enjoy the set so much. So of course we are in that big stompy game plan, but of course we do want to win the game. If we don't have a way to win, what's the point of playing Commander? I mean, of course you want to have fun, but if you are in a more high powered setting, of course you want to play more to win in that style. So of course, I kind of went with more extra combats because I feel like extra combats can kind of get you those extra points of damage, especially when you have huge dinosaurs on the battlefield. So Last Night Together, Seize the Day, and Relentless Assault are great options for you to get those extra combats. I especially like Last Night Together because it gives your two dinosaurs Vigilance, Indestructible, and Haste, and 2/1/1 counters on them. If you do want to get infinite combats in this deck, you could use a card like Aggravated Assault and Poetic Ingenuity. This is a way to get extra combats, mainly because if you have 5 or more dinosaurs attacking, you make that many treasure tokens. So If you attack with five dinosaurs, you're going to make five treasure tokens. You can pay into the aggravated assault so that you can keep going and then get infinite combats that way. But of course, another way you can win, and this is one that I feel like is a very splashy way to win, is using Savala, Heart of the Wild, Staff of Domination, and Finale of Devastation. This is a lot of ways I plan to win in most cases, especially in my Xenagos God of Rebels deck, but this is a great combo because each of these cards are great by themselves. Savala, Heart of the Wilds can be a great card draw engine for us, and on top of that, a great mana accelerant. Staff of Domination could either draw some cards, untap our creatures, tap a creature if they do have a Blightsteel Colossus, and you can keep reusing that ability the more mana you do have. And Finale of Devastation is a great tutor, but it could be a great win con giving all our creatures haste if we pay 10 or more into that cost. And so if we add all these together, we could get infinite mana with Savala, Heart of the Wilds, and Staff of Domination if we do have a big enough creature. Then we could draw our whole entire deck, pull our whole entire deck on the battlefield, then pay all that mana to Finale Devastation for the win. So there is one way you can win in this deck if you choose so. I do like Finale Devastation, especially for the art. I'm a big sucker for that art because it does have dinosaurs, and of course we are in a dinosaur deck, so we want to kind of go forward with that game plan. However, that's going to do it for me, guys. Thank you guys so much for coming by and watching this video on Blue and Owen. I feel like this is going to be my favorite commander deck, one of my favorite commander decks of all time, because of course I'm playing dinosaurs and I'm also playing cards from Jurassic Park. What more can I want? And I hope you are excited as I am, because this is a very awesome and very special deck to me, because I absolutely love the Jurassic Park franchise. It's something that I cherished for a long time, and I never thought that Magic and Jurassic Park would cross over together, but here we are today. Let me know down below in the comments, is there anything that you would change personally for yourself? Also, again, I did want to thank Into the AM for sponsoring this video. Again, you can check out the link down below in the description so that you can get 10% off your order. And so with all that said, make sure to like, share, and subscribe to the channel. And with that out of the way, thank you for stopping by.